Hello everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to discuss about a topic that I discovered very recently, but I think everyone in the world should know this and understand the whole concept to live a better or more productive life. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. So recently, I just winded up a batch of Photoshop learners. That is, I used to give coaching as a Photoshop trainer for these people. And in that batch, there was one person who was very enthusiastic, who used to take notes of everything that I gave, who watched every video lecture that I posted, and has also watched each and every YouTube tutorials that I recommended. So he was one of the best students in the class, but still he was not improving at the rate the others were. So that gave me the question, what is actually happening and why is he not improving? Because as I saw it, this guy was the most interested and the most involved person in the class. And why was he not improving like just like the others? So when I asked him and we had a chat in person, I found out that this guy did not spend time practicing as much as he spent time learning the theory and learning everything behind it. And the rest of the people, even though they did not take the video lesson seriously, even though they did not watch a ton of YouTube tutorials, they did practice Photoshop, and that's exactly why they were better than him on Photoshop. Because Photoshop is practical and you have to be practical. And this is not just about Photoshop. I'm sure we all have been in the space where we spent hours and hours watching tutorials, YouTube videos, and all the courses online that we don't actually try anything out and we don't get the results that we want. That's because we are in that state of toxic productivity. We think that we are doing something good by learning something new every single day and doing something very productive, but in return, we are actually wasting time. We are just watching the courses or how to do videos because we don't want to do it, or we just want to procrastinate doing it. And that's why we spend time learning this so that we can avoid doing it. But how to avoid this? How to avoid the toxic productivity sector and be more productive in real? So this video, I'm gonna give you 5 steps that you can use to avoid being toxic productive and actually be productive and be a better person or be a better learner. So the first step is to know what you want in the long run. Know your goals and know where you want to be after like 6 months or an year of doing the thing that you're doing right now. Just knowing what to do will pave the path for the next step, that is to actually create a blueprint of the things that you have to do to reach your goal. You know what to do because of the first step. So now the step you have to take is to do a blueprint or make a clear roadmap of the things that you have to do to get there. So once you have the roadmap, you know clearly the things that you have to do every single day so that you are not overwhelming yourself, and also so that you're not wasting a lot of time doing things that don't matter. The third step that you have to do is to balance the work and learning time. We usually spend a lot of time learning and very less time working, and that's exactly what you should not be doing. And you have to invest a lot of time into working and doing things practically rather than just doing things theoretically and just learning about it. The fourth step or the fourth thing that you have to do is to stop overwhelming yourself with a lot of value. I know the internet is a great place and there is a lot of value on the internet and there is a lot of courses that you can take from. And for example, just to create a YouTube thumbnail, there are like 3000 tutorials on YouTube. So you don't have to watch all 3000 tutorials to create a good thumbnail. You just have to practice and practice to be a better thumbnail creator. And that's exactly what you should do. Avoid overwhelming yourself with value. Avoid taking thousands of courses just to do one simple thing. Instead, practice and try to be better by yourself. The last and the most important tip that I can give you is to actually note down the time you spend learning and the time you spend doing that stuff. So every time you learn something new and you spend time doing it, note down both the time spans. At least make sure that you're working twice as time as the time you spend learning, So once you have the details about the exact number of hours you have spent into learning and the number of hours you have spent practicing, you will have a clear idea about the places where you are wasting time, or you'll at least know when you are learning too much and not implementing it at all in real life. So these were the five things that you can do to avoid being productively toxic or toxic productivity. So that's it for this video. I hope this was helpful, and I hope you will have a great learning experience further on. So I am Ajnish Rao signing off. That's it for this video. I'll see you in the next one. Until then, peace.